I'm Robyn Horn. I started out being a wood turner, and now I consider myself a wood sculptor. And now I've started painting, so it's kind of getting to where you might as well just say I'm an artist. My brother-in-law took a class at Aramont School in 84, I guess it was, and he came back. We were sharing a shop at the time, and he came back to work on pieces, and we would hear this big noise, bam, where the wood piece would hit the wall, and we'd go in there and ask him what was going on, you know, and he'd have a crash helmet on, and he'd be sitting on top of the lathe, and it was an exciting thing to do, and he said, do you want to try it? So I did, and started making things, and the lathe is a really good tool to help you make things easily round. But then I got to where I was tired of round and wanted to branch out, so I started doing more carving. My back started hurting me so much I was afraid I was gonna have to quit making art, so I decided that painting might be something that I'd want to try to get back into after I'd done some in college, but hadn't really gotten into it enough to know what I was doing, so I didn't have much education in color, so all of a sudden, instead of brown, you're dealing with color, which was kind of a shocking experience, but I seem to have waded through it a little bit, and because I'd worked in wood for so long and had looked at art for so long, I had developed enough of an aesthetic to know more what I felt like was good and what wasn't, or what worked and what didn't. I have a certain color palette that I particularly like that involves the colors that wood are, basically rust and browns and kind of more muted colors. I like things that are minimal. I like things that have balance issues, things that maybe appear to be something they're not, which is what my work makes. Essentially is the Slipping Stone series particularly is has those characteristics. The textures that I use are determined pretty much by the tools that I have. But there is a repetition of form that I like to use with the surfaces as well as with the overall form of the sculpture. People are attracted to wood, they want to touch it. So if you have something that feels really good too, that's a plus. Well, I'm really kind of into the painting right now. I've added wire and charcoal and rust to the acrylics. And that seems to be where my head is right now. But Sandy and I are gonna do a few more large sculptures, and I'm looking forward to that. So I'll be going back and forth from one to the other, and I won't ever be able to give up wood. It's something that you just have to do. You can't not make things. It's very simple to me, and it's like an emotional experience that you have, and it feeds you. It's a very basic thing for me.